If you use Lightroom Mobile, these 10 tricks are seriously too good to miss, and watch till the end of the video to not miss out on a bonus tip. Let's start with the clipping warnings. Tuning highlights, shadows, whites or blacks can be confusing sometimes, and you never know if it is actually the result you want because of the brightness of your display you are working on. If you want a visual cue of how these sliders are affecting the image, you can slide with two fingers, and when you see these white spots popping, the details are getting lost in these parts of the image. In this instance, increasing whites to this value has resulted in overexposing these parts. Basically, it's all white, so no details. So make sure you move the slider carefully to avoid these spots popping up if you want a perfectly exposed image. Similarly, if you move black slider towards left with two fingers and see black spots, these areas are now completely black. One way to fine-tune this is working with highlights and shadows first. When you move highlight slider towards left, you start getting more details in the brighter areas. Similarly, increasing shadows results more details in darker areas. Now you have more room to play with whites and black slider. Now you have the image as flat as possible, and this is a good starting point to edit your images. If you go to detail and sharpening, increasing the sharpening amount results in weird looking image, especially if it affects the parts on the sky here. To control it, you can use the masking slider with two fingers. If the value is at the leftmost point of the slider, the sharpening effect affects the whole image with the mask completely white. Sliding it towards right with two fingers, you see the selection is getting fine-tuned. Stopping here, you can see the sky completely black. So sharpening effect doesn't reflect on these parts, and the result is a lot more pleasing to the eyes. One more example on how this can be used if there is a main subject in the image. It can sharpen only the fine parts of the main subject, leaving the others as it is, in turn popping only the main subject. The targeted color tool in HSL sliders, that is in color mix in the color menu. Instead of guessing which color slider affects that particular area in your image, you can literally touch any part in the image and adjust the color. Tap on this and drag on any part of the photo up or down, right or left to increase or decrease its value. For example, tapping on this red area and sliding down is reducing the hues of both reds and oranges as you see here. So we don't need to guess what colors are here. Tapping and sliding is enough to see what colors are affected. Tapping here on the greens also shows there are both greens and yellows in this vegetation as shown here in the right. Moving left turns them to orange hues, right towards cyan colors. Tapping on saturation, you see now it increases or decreases the saturation. Similarly, the luminance tap and slide. You can see the brightness is getting affected on the yellows and oranges. For this image, you can see I have not only tuned the colors, I have further added some masking filters to the image, including the one to create the bright sun and darkening the sky a bit. What if I want to copy the settings of this image to the other? Copying the masking filters doesn't make sense as the images are completely different. So, if you tap on this three-dot menu and copy settings, you can choose which particular setting to be copied. I want to mainly copy the color settings from here and couple others which may be useful. Selecting masking tool and moving to this image and pasting the settings has resulted in this weird spot, the radial filter from the earlier image. So it is better to copy only the settings you need. Still, you can remove the effects on this image too if you don't need. Also tune the colors and change them. This time, I will only copy the relevant settings and paste them here. The major work of copying color grading is completed. You can still make small changes to fine-tune the image. Basically, if you want to flatten the image to get a good starting point, you start using the sliders in the light menu. There is other way to get the same results, but can be done more selectively, which is more flexible. In the masking filters, for example, I can select subjects separately and work on that to brighten in this instance. Selecting background separately and tuning the highlights and shadows for a more accurate tuning of those particular areas. This you can see gives the same results. You can go further by adding more masking filters to make further local adjustments. Removing distractions is another must-know feature. Such good photos can have distracting parts on them. In the remove menu, using healing tool is the way to go here. You can resize the brush depending on the parts you want to erase. Just brushing on this sign, we can see the result. A very quick way to clean up your photos. Brush size is too big here. Reducing it to a smaller size and brushing. Brushing each distraction separately will get better results. This tip is handy for seeing our progress without fumbling through menus. It's so simple, so many people miss it. Just tap and hold to see the original image, an easy way to look at before and after the edits you made so far. There is an easy way to get film look without going into color menu, and that is with curves in the light menu. You can not only fine-tune the exposure, but also add colors here. First, I will darken the shadows and brighten the highlights to give contrast to the overall image. Now we'll lift the blacks to get a hint of faded look to the image and also bring down the whites to soften the image a bit. Now with the blue curve selected, we will add some split toning to the image. Dragging the shadows towards left adds blue color to the darker areas, and moving the highlights towards left adds warmer tones to the highlights as the color yellow is opposite of blue. And you can see the before and after, a soft output film look. If you are still unsure on how to correct the exposure of an image manually, you can just use the auto button. The auto button is there both under light menu and quick actions. You can use either of them. You can see the sliders, and this is almost the perfect flat image to start your edits. If you want to go for film look, of course you have the choice to slide these manually. If you want to quickly correct the perspective of an image, especially shot at a low angle, you just need to go to the crop menu and tap on this edit button. Here, slide the vertical slider towards left till you straighten the edges of the building and to your liking. This also results in white areas around the few edges and corners. You don't need to manually crop this. There is this constraint crop toggle which crops the image perfectly, leaving the white areas. Now a bonus tip at the end. You can create your own preset, and it is quite easy. As you saw earlier, on this image I did tune the curves and also will do little more tunings in the stencil sliders now. Here in the three dot menu, I will tap on create preset and you get these options to choose. I don't want these optics and the others saved in the preset. You can even go into submenus and choose which to enable and which not to. We'll name the preset here to something like this. Now if you want to apply this on any other images, for example, I have this image opened. Open the presets menu. Here you can find the saved preset in the viewers tab. After selecting the preset, it is applied on the image with all the sliders tuned. Also, you can control the amount of intensity of this preset on this image. Just slide left or right to reduce or increase the intensity of the preset on the image. You can also see here all the sliders already tuned from the earlier preset, and you can change the values if you want. So there you have it, some seriously underrated Lightroom mobile tricks that will take your editing to the next level. Let me know your favorite in the comments. Subscribe and ring the bell so you don't miss more of my videos. Thanks for watching.